Whenever I make fresh jelly, I always clean the pot by making me a little foldy sandwich and have it with a glass of milk. This is blackberry jelly. These are from a mixture of our tame blackberries and our just wild ones that go around our house. I just usually, when I harvest the ones from our tame ones, I just make a trip and see what I can harvest from the wild ones too. So good. So very good. One of my favorite things about making jelly, of course, in addition to getting to eat the wonderful jelly all through the coming winter. This made about 6 little pints is all that I made today. One of them I'm going to leave up here because we're out of jelly. So that just means I just have 5 pints. So I'll have to be making more jelly this summer so that we'll have it to eat in the coming winter.
See it? So now you'll know for future reference for y'all. I've got it weighted down with a rock.
Cool. Because
that's a deep place up there.
That is cool.
Good watermelon?
Yep.
Salt?
Yep, you gotta have salt on the watermelon. Or I do.
I'm so pleased with the beets. Not a bad harvest at all. I'm going to have enough to pickle, and I think I'm going to have enough left over from that that we can enjoy them tonight for supper and maybe even another night. I'll have to wait and see. Depends on how many runs of pickles I make, actually. But I'm really, really pleased because it's been so long since we were able to grow beets. When I was pulling up the beets, I found this little tree growing. There's some ground cherries growing here, and then the okra is just right here. And there's the tree. It's hiding by the beets. Amazing how nature just takes back over when you're not looking.
So every once in a while you'll have a jar of something that doesn't seal. These beets, they didn't seal. When I press on that, it gives has some give in the tap. So I'm going to put them in the refrigerator and we will enjoy them first.